This is the Olie Baker type spring winder. I believe that Merits and Time Saver still sells it. It's a heavy duty unit. It comes working right out of the box. It's got a nice little ratchet that you can flip its direction. And it utilizes these double-sided winding arbors that you get when you buy the letdown kit that simply pops it right in there. So it's one purpose fits all. And what you do is you take your barrel and you find a winding adapter that fits it properly. Put it inside there. Put the barrel in there. Move the tailstock up, which locks the unit in there so it's not going to jump out at you. And you look at the way the spring winds. Make sure you wear gloves and eye protection. And what we're going to do is, I forgot something. See, once we wind it up inside that barrel, we're going to have to capture that spring inside there. So, let me find one that fits. Okay, we got the barrel with the spring in it, and now we have the adapter, the actual spring clamp itself, and you want to make sure that little horseshoe part of it goes into the barrel. And you see this play that we have in there? You want to have a little bit of play in there. This way, when the spring compresses down all the way, that it'll fit inside this hole, and a little horseshoe part will go around where the spring is actually wrapped around its little rivet. Where is it? There it is. See the little rivet there? Well, the horseshoe part's going to go around there. And you want to torque the clamp either in one direction or the other direction so you have the most amount of spring hanging out of this particular slot. That's very important because once you get it inside the clamp, you got to be able to grab a hold of that loose end in order to take it out of that spring clamp. Oh, here I almost did it again. You want to put it in there with the horseshoe facing the barrel, just like that. Tighten it down. And I just generally just grab it with my free hand here, and as I'm winding it, it'll simply, you can hear it goes, a lot of boinging going on there. Come to think of it, what I like to do, which I forgot to tell you, is have the rivet facing upwards when you grab it, because you can't look for the rivet after it's wound up, otherwise you'll release it. So we'll go ahead and wind it up like that. Then we put in the clamp and we turn it so we have the most amount sticking out. And then we switch the direction of the winder and unwind the spring into the clamp, just like that. Now that it's inside the clamp, we can now turn it and release it out of there. See the way that thing is being held? And now we have enough of the spring hanging out that we can grab a hold of this and get it out of this. Tailstock back on. It's got a little hook here. I like to use the larger hook. Like that. Switch the direction. Put the glove back on in case something explodes. All right. right now the spring is not catching. Okay, I got it to catch and I wound it up and now it's released out of here. And now we unwind it. And there's your spring. We can actually leave it right on there because all we want to do is inspect it, clean it. Back. I need to get a little paper towel. Just before we clean it, you notice that this thing is about 4.5 inches in diameter. This brings up the subject of whether the spring is set or not. If you were to buy this spring brand new and have it relaxed like this, it would probably be more like 11 inches to 15 inches in diameter. Some people would say that this one is set, but if you do your pivoting and bushing work and your polishing work correctly, the clock almost needs no power to work, and a spring like this will have more than enough power to run it for the 8 days, sometimes even further. I know if I put a brand new spring on some of my American clocks and run it, it'll run between 12 to 14 days, and that's only an 8 day clock. So I think I can get 8 days out of this guy and I don't have to bother ordering another one. Now, as I'm cleaning this particular spring, I'm going to also be looking at it to see if there's any cracking or irregularities in the metal. If there is, I'm going to get rid of it and put new springs in. But I think it should be okay. WD-40 is not a lubricant. It is a great cleaner, though. You can use WD, it's relatively inexpensive, and so I use it as a cleaner. Put a little bit in a paper towel and stretch out the spring. Now when you stretch the spring out, it will probably be larger than that 4.5 inches in diameter. Don't let that fool you, because as soon as you put it into the barrel, it's going to get small again very quickly. That's one of the reasons why you never want to bend the spring backwards to try to make it bigger in diameter, because you're actually breaking the molecular backbone of the metal and it's just not going to last. So okay, I see some irregularities here. It's towards the inside, though, where very little movement happens. Can you see those stripes on the spring? I feel bumps here. And generally, when you see bumps like that, that has to do with the arbor. The arbor. Spring. This is the arbor right here. Sometimes the arbor has a little locking piece that's a little bit too large, but this one looks like it's in good shape. So let's go ahead and stretch this guy back out again and wipe off the WD. Sure you don't let go of the spring. You'll either hurt yourself or wherever the spring goes flying to. And in my case, it'll hit the camera. So hopefully you got your eye protection on. Look at all this dirt I'm getting off of there. Personally, I don't like the smell of WD, but it's cheap cleaner, so what the hell. cleans off the bench kind of nice. And that's it. I guess, oh, look at that, the spring is only about a half an inch greater in diameter. So what we're going to do here is this one's ready to pop back into the barrel, and only after it goes into the barrel will I actually lubricate it. But the WD does have to evaporate, so I think I'm going to wipe it off one more time. Put it back in the barrel. So we need to put it first into the spring clamp. We put the hook on it. Try to center this little catch on the bottom here, centered on the spring itself. Otherwise the spring is going to wind kind of funny. Before you get too far into it, make sure you got gloves on in case something slips. Well, that looks like it's going to slip. So I'm going to swap around the tailstock, this little piece here, so it hooks in from the other side. Let's move it around. Get rid of this one, flip this around, get rid of the little one. It's got three little catches on that thing, depending on which one you want to use. Hard to see what you're doing when you're wearing this magnifiers. Okay, let's put the spring back over where it should be. You got this entire assembly centered correctly, it'll wind up much easier. Okay, it's all wound up. You put the horseshoe in there and twist it so you get a little extra sticking out there. Release the ratchet. And now that's in. Just like that. The barrel itself, I didn't actually clean out the barrel yet, but I'm going to take a look at it at the same time. This is the barrel that's got that little cut in it. Right there on the side of the barrel, but it also has that little rivet, which is good. Okay, so what we're going to do now is release this guy, install him into the barrel. Hopefully you can see everything I'm doing. The rivet part you want to have go right here. Oh, you can't see that. Right here is where you want the rivet part to be. So the rivet, position it so it's right over there. We press the spring in like that. Oh, the barber just fell out. And push in the spring clamp. And then mount it back up again. And now, if everything goes right, I put the rivet so it's facing up again. Okay, got that. And there it is. It's in. And it's hooked up correctly. We're going to do the other two barrels exactly the same way. If I find anything wrong with the barrels, I'll get back on camera and show it to you. But if I don't find anything wrong, I'm going to have the other two finished.